I mentioned that the Tigers were annihilated here last year by 137 points. I don't think that will happen today. Under Jeff Geeshan late last season, they really did turn it around, and they now are a very competitive
screen. The Tigers keen to get revenge for what happened here last year when they were absolutely flogged by the Adelaide Crows. Campbell in solidly on Jarman. A quick kick comes out of the pack and James takes the mark, short of half forward.
Costa going with Knights at the opening bounce.
And you would say with that slight breeze, James too far out to score, looking for options. And now goes back, perhaps indicating he's going to kick the ball long, which he does. Gets underneath it a little bit. And as Neil pointed out earlier, that sun's certainly going to be a factor. Campbell, here's a chance for first goal. Jams it in, bang, and puts it through for the Crows.
Well, Dougie, it was pretty smart play there by Adelaide, without any doubt. Bond just waited until they cleared that space 30 metres out from the top of the square, and he poked it into that space, as they did so successfully last week.
Yeah, good start by Adelaide there, Gerard, as you just said there. As you said, Costa certainly has the job on Knight, and as well, Matt Connor looks like he might be following Daffy as well.
Rod Jamieson, former winner of the goal kicking for the Adelaide Crows. That's going back a few seasons now. He's played a lot in defence, of course, since then. Crows swing into attack again. Knights goes down in the tackle. Umpire lets it go. Quick kick off the ground by Michael Gale. Bickley. Skipper's kick well inside 50. That's about as far as it's going. Harrison.
Interesting, Harrison starting across the half back line.
Had to look twice. Daffy. Kicks the half forward. Chance now for Evans. Takes it from Powell. Richardson. Good gather. Gee, that's pretty close. No score. Gee, it must have been right on the line. Wren wraps it up. That's it. The Crows defend for the first time in the match. Well, Jarman down in defence.
Well, he started at that last centre bounce, and we may well see Jeff Geeshan put Matthew Knights onto Darren Jarman at some stage just to break the tag, because he is getting heavily tagged, scragged at this stage by Kim Costa.
Sean Wren has been mentioned as one of the favourites for the Brownlow. I don't think too many would argue with that at the moment. Bassett's kick over to Smart on his own. In fact, there's not a Richmond player within 35 metres of him. Nigel Smart, from right half-back, puts the Crows into attack again. Ball bouncing beautifully. Tyson, a former Tiger himself. That might be out of bounds. Did he keep it in? He didn't, Jamieson. Well, the boundary umpire, who was about 45 metres behind the play, decides it will be thrown in.
Big that call this one, Dougie.
Gee.
I reckon that was certainly in, Gerard. No doubt the replay shows that.
Keating. Gets front position, that's all. Doesn't get the footy. Knights. Chance to gather it in. Crows are plenty. James kicks out. Only to see Knights on the end of it. Offloads it to Harrison. Kicks it to the man on the mark. Snapshot by Eccles. Misses. Gets the minor part of the prize.
Smart play, young Eccles, Doug. It's great to see young talent coming through, and we saw him kick a number of goals last week to really put his hand up to say he's arrived as a footballer.
Yeah, great smother there. Good call, Peter, there. And the thing with Harrison, too, Jared, he certainly started half-back last week, too, against Melbourne, so maybe they do that and then maybe bring him forward later in the game.
Scotty Turner, Gale, who's been having a very good season. Much fitter than I think I've ever seen him. Keating in front. Got a fingernail to it. Gasper was there as well, who's also having a good season. Speaking of players in form. And just throw in right in the middle of the interchange gates.
And Jared, you caught it earlier before the game started. Nathan Bassett has the job on Richardson, as you did say.
Yeah, pretty tough one. And they're going pretty tall, the Tigers, because Holland's down there also being picked up by Hart.
Tawney. Oh, not Tawney. It was Tyson. And Neil Curley is on the
boys,
boundary line.
Do you see Brad Evans as a surprise choice of centre-half forward? That's an unusual one.
Well, they've got a fair few reps on him, Neil, and I think that they'll be looking for someone perhaps to play almost in a negative role on Caven, because he's such an attacking player for the Crows.
Jarman's kick. Tyson. Turner nearly into his back. Jamison's hand pass. Bond. James. This could be another one. Barty's kick. Could have done better. One behind. Golden opportunity missed there. Perfect setup.
Ashley Prescott is picking up Mark Ricciuto, who was in devastating form last week. Gasper and Keating, Doug, is going to be an interesting battle. Gasper's had a tremendous season, and Keating just starting to show some good form over the last few weeks.
Yeah, Gasper was brilliant last week, Jared. He gave plenty of run to the Richmond defence and done a great job on David Schwartz, cut him right out of the game. So that will be a very even contest, I think.
Rogers. Scotty Turner looking right into the sun. It's going to be difficult kicking in from that end. A little bit of body work by Gale. Gasper, Keating's got him, has to get rid of it quickly. Great tackle, but brushed aside by Gale, who kicks up towards half forward. Richardson. McLeod. Hard. Off the side of the boot. Purposely. Ricciuto. A little bit of a nudge. Gasper. Keating taken out of the contest. Bond from Rogers. Onto the left. Kicks it short. Jamison. Good mark.
And the light of the ground players of the Crows that really got their act together early in this game. The likes of Rintoul, James and Bond. And if they throw Darren Jarman down there, they've got such a fleet-footed group of goal kickers that they're going to be tough to stop in perfect conditions.
Yeah, Jamison very quick over 10 metres. There may be a bit of a problem there for Scotty Turner in that pace department.
So Rod Jamison for his second goal. Is it coming back?
Oh.
It looks okay. It's there. Jamison gets his seconds, and the Tigers, who really only bit into attack once, the Zilch, trailed by 14 points.
Yeah, great start to the Crows here at Goodie Park, and once again, as I said, I saw Richmond last week, and they had a lot of problems up in their half forward line, and as Neil Curley said, with Evans playing at centre half forward, there's a bit of a problem there. Maybe Richardson may need to come up the ground a bit more.
By Brian Sheehan to put it down again.
And both sides starting with an extra man in defence. Bickley's alone for the Crows, and I would imagine that's because Ben Harrison has started as a spare man for the Tigers in defence.
Jarman again starting at the centre square, in the circle. As the Crows try to run it forward, they don't have the success here that they would have wanted. And that could almost be a push in the back to Powell, but the umpire says no siree. Throw it in. Yes, it was Ted High and Joel Bowden.
It's going to be an interesting battle between Bowden and Nigel Smart, two brilliant players. And I would imagine both will kick goals this afternoon.
Ricciuto, Prescott. Gale, a little give tonight. That was Michael Gale. Back into the Richmond side. Daffy loves a goal. Needs to bend that one around. He's kicked it. First blood to Richmond.
Well, he's quite an extraordinary player at times, Nick Daffy. He throws the ball on the boot so quickly. Often he, I think, does it without full knowledge that he's got more time than he has to just steady and balance. Just have a look at this. He is clear. He could keep running into goal, but he just throws it on the boot. Sometimes it works for him, as that one did.
Yeah, I wonder, Jared, if he was going for the pass to Richardson in the goal score. I'm not quite sure on that one, but certainly the goal was there. So good play by the Tigers.
Great goal by Daffy. You posed the question during the break, Doug, whether it was intended to be a pass, but I don't think he'll want it back just the same. Wren. Harrison. Cave it underneath Evans. And he gets it. Looks for a hand pass to Bowden. Good tackle, Smart in the back. Not a good tackle.
Interesting.
What do you think of that?
Well, just going back to the previous one, Ben Harrison started in the centre bounce and took the ball away. I was following him, Peter, and not looking at the action.
Well, often you get controversy. Push in the back, good tackle. So Holland. Judging by Daffy's kick, distance shouldn't be a problem, and wind is certainly not really a factor. If anything, it's going Richmond's way. but virtually windless here today. Oh, hit the post.
It looks like he might have got one right on the snoz. And Ben Holland, who is a terrific shot at goal these days. He's obviously done a lot of work under his numerous coaches over the last few years. He's got a very copybook style, though.
He certainly has, Gerard. He's got a good pair of hands, too. And interesting to see, as you said, Jarman playing the midfield, picked up by Duncan Callaway.
That's it to Hart. As the Crows work it out of defence. And they come away now through Connell. Up to midfield. Smart, getting a lot of possessions early in the game. Bond.
Connell's run right across from the other side of the wing.
Out of bounds, right half forward. Connell, former best and fairest for the Adelaide Crows. Won that back in 1995. And Phil said it was warm down there, and Keating would be pretty warm in that helmet, I'd reckon, today. Prescott. Goes for the boundary line and gets it again right in the middle of the interchange gates. Be a good duel that one, McLeod and Daffy.
He started picking up Powell, and Powell, one suspects, is pushed onto the ball. They must just have shuffled their midfielders to the touch.
Harrison again did well off one step, kicks it down towards left half forward. Powell takes the hand pass from Evans, centering kick. Could have been delivered a little bit better, but two Richmond players are there. Harrison takes the hand pass at half court, kicks it goal, gets Richmond second. Well, he's covering a bit of territory. I saw him in defence only a minute back.
I think he's actually moved into a midfield role, which is a most interesting move by the coach, but one that has paid dividends early in the match, though.
Yeah, Steve Richardson here picked the football up. On his left-hand side, he had Michael Gale, who probably could have given the football. It was totally clear. The, okay, the option was to Ben Harris. Okay, worked out well, but Gale was there as well.
Richardson's hand pass to Harrison, resulting in Richmond's second goal, and the difference back to 2 points. In fact, 1 point. 14 plays 13, 13 minutes left in the first quarter. And you'd reckon already we're going to be seeing a high-scoring game. Campbell's kick up the half forward. Off the hands of the pack, Evans dragged, might have been taken high. Umpire lets it go. Evans kicks to right half forward. Should be, and in fact is a Richmond mark taken by Callaway. Two Callaways in the Richmond side today. Knights kick up towards centre wing. And the skipper has it marked down there by Bowden.
And Jeff Geeshan has continued to experiment with this midfield, and he's pushed Matthew Knights for the second week in a row back to the half back line.
Prescott from Gale. Well, that's a mammoth kick. That is a mammoth kick.
That's the way you want it delivered into the forward line, Doug.
That's the way you got to do it, Jared. I'll tell you what, young Holland's got a great pair of hands. It could be a bit of a test there for Ben Hart, particularly in the air in a one-on-one contest.
Doug, you played in a memorable victory here for the Roy boys. They've done it well, the Tigers. You've got to get on top early.
You've got to go on top early. Yeah, back at Fitzroy 95. It was fantastic, Jared.
He's hit the post once, but that's a goal. Richmond in front.
Well, what a start to this game by the Tigers. A lot of punters were saying that if there was to be an upset today, that this may well have been the one. And, well, you see there, the ball brought in so quickly that they implement or force a one-on-one situation. And it's going to be tough for any player to counter this man in a one-on-one duel.
So it's the Tigers after Adelaide got the first two goals. Richmond kicked the next three. The difference, 5 points. Bounce favours Wren, James. In the thick of things early, Keating so nearly brought it down. Gasper, but shepherded by Michael Gale. Goes past Callaway, looks for Harrison. From Connell. Gets it back again from Duncan Callaway. Decides to kick long. Caven in the front. McLeod. They share it around. Jarman. Tyson. Gale nearly. Got him. Close to the boundary line. Out of bounds, in fact, on centre wing. curls. You've got something for us?
Yeah, I think at ground level here you'll find that Richmond are going to the favoured end, not only with the wind, but also with their forward not having to contend with the sun.
Yeah, that's a real factor, isn't it? Something you don't think of this time of the year.
Perfect one day, better the next here in Adelaide, Philip.
I hope he's got his factor 15 on. A real scramble there. Opportunity for Tawney. Rogers number four. And then again out of bounds.
Jared, the move of Ben Harrison playing that like a loose man in the fence or maybe in that midfield, had 8 or 9 possessions already. It's been a good move by Geeshan.
Well, it may just work for a quarter, but it's had its desired effect, getting the Tigers into a competitive position early in the first quarter. And if you can just keep a lid on the home sides in these one team or two team, one town situations, then you've got a pretty good start.
Gale and Wren go at it again. Michael Gale, tackled by Wren. Prescott's all tied up, and the umpire will ball it up again.
Just at the moment, Sean Wren hasn't been able to get into this match.
Well, it was Jarman, really, has he?
No, he's had a couple of possessions, but certainly hasn't had them forward to the centre where he does so much damage. And if Gale can just nullify the influence of Wren, I'm sure his coach would be pretty pleased.
Punch away there, Evans. Now Duncan Callaway from midfield. Callaway out wide towards left half forward. It's a one-on-one contest. Daffy from Richardson. Oh, Mark should have been swallowed by Prescott. And he may get a free kick. Held quite a long way in the tackle. Duncan Callaway's kick. McLeod. Kicks to a contest on centre wing. Very sandy part of the ground. Keating, Campbell. May have been taken high. Crowd wants holding the ball. Tyson, good shepherd by Keating. His kick up towards right half forward for the Crows. Knocked away, knocked on by Rogers actually. Bond off the ground. Very hard to kick goals from there. In fact, the ball nearly out of bounds. Boundary umpire says okay. Knight's taken out of that contest. Oh, Vardy. Just about knocked out. Knights. Beautiful vision. Callaway. Campbell. Campbell, 15-metre hand pass to Daffy, who kicked Richmond's first goal. Kicks towards half forward, and the mark is there. It's taken by Evans, who's doing well so far.
What's happened here, Jared? Darren Jarman's gone forward or gone in the midfield. It looks like now that Duncan Callaway's just sitting off him and playing a kick behind the play.
Brett Evans played for Springvale and their premiership sides, 95 and 96. He's played 17 games in the reserves for Richmond, including the premiership last year. That kick won't be a goal. There he is again, Holland.
Just too big at the moment. He's got Ben Hart as a direct opponent. And there's a fair bit of shepherding behind him by Matthew Richardson, who may well have just impeded the second man up. It's defensive strategy. But once again, this is a almost a certain goal and a great start by Richmond. And it's been the midfield dominance that's set this game up.
I said before, Vardy was just about knocked out, and he's going to be out of the game, at least for a while, to be replaced by Rintour.
Well, I think you're right.
Crook. He's crook.
He is as crook as you'd want to be Saturday afternoon.
Holland gets the goal, his second. He's kicked 2-1. And that one was a poster. So Ben Holland having a real influence on the game here in the first quarter as the Tigers have kicked the last 4 unanswered goals.
Midfield dominance, getting the ball across the half-back line. The Crows haven't been able to penetrate into their forward 50 for some 5 to 7 minutes. Evans has taken a couple of grabs, which has given them a focal point. And this young man has done the rest.
Two goals won by Ben Holland, proving a real handful. Difference out to 11 points in favour of Richmond. Wren.
Oh, brilliant work,
Seth James. Callaway tries to punch and does it effectively. Keating tried to get it out to Bond, not as effectively. Campbell does it well. Harrison, they share it around from Tawney.
10 possessions.
Which is quite remarkable at this stage of the first quarter. Evans and Caven. Connor. Roping kick, Tawney underneath it, Gasper. It's some pretty good support. Evans again, Caven, this time defensively and effectively out of bounds.
I think with the height factor down in the forward line for Richmond, with Ben Holland, I reckon maybe Malcolm Blight may need to put Smart maybe back on the Holland and put Hart up the ground onto Bowden. That might be a good move for Malcolm Blight.
Yeah, certainly makes sense from a height perspective as we see
Scotty Turner take out Vardy. And he's still sitting on the bench. He's not too good. Curls might have some news for us on that shortly as Rogers takes the mark at right half back. Goes inboard. Prescott. As you mentioned, Hawke, he's in a bit of form at the moment. Smart. Good effective punch. This is a great game of footy. Ideal conditions. It's almost like a finals atmosphere, weather-wise at least. James. Wren. For standing start to half forward, and the Crows want something here. They're not going to get it. Gaspar marking in front of Keating. Campbell on the Gale. It's Benny Gale. He'll look for Tawney going past. Richardson. Oh, yes, nearly the mark. Kicked off the ground past Caven. Has to make ground. Holland again. Oh, thump. Connell. Crows defence under a lot of pressure in the last 10 minutes or so. Snapshot by Bowden. Is off target. The mark, is it there? Umpire's paid it to Peter Caven.
In fact, I think it was a pretty fair kick by Bowden, Peter. He definitely snapped it to the top of the square. I'm sure that'd be team rules, but unfortunately, wasn't a tiger on the end of it.
James. Keating. Well, still can't hold the marks. He's got his hands on the ball quite a few times, but hasn't been able to drag it in. Good smother there by the big fellow. Maybe a turnover here can suit the Crows. Ricciuto. Jamison, who kicked their first goal, outside 50. Good block there by Turner. Knights. Well, Richmond playing with a lot of commitment so far. Turner to Campbell. Gale, kick behind the play. Wren comes at him. Holland again. Oh, hard lost sight of it in the sun. As Neil Curley mentioned, that's certainly a factor. Down to Curls.
Yeah, I think the pitcher told the story there with young Vardy. He suffered a heavy knock to the head. The doctors checked him out. There is slight concussion, so I have to wait to see if he can take any further part in the game.
David Pittman about to come on. Curls, would he go into the ruck and Wren forward, or are they concerned about Ben Holland in defence?
I think he might be concerned about centre-half forward at this stage.
Yep.
McLeod. Smart. Gale. Eccles.
Just great
missed
pressure
it
from the Tigers, causing a turnover.
Well, that's starting across their half-back line. They've certainly got their tails up now. Powell. Delivers it well, Bowden. McLeod, a great tackle, son. The commitment of both sides, tremendous. Bowden again. That man is just too tall.
Good call from Neil Curley there with Keating coming off the ground and Pittman on the take on Gaspar.
Jarman. Well, he really hasn't been able to get into the play, which is surprising. You'd think conditions today made for him. Up to midfield, Bickley. Just wants to steady the ship a little bit for the Crows. Went into the match as fairly warm favourites. Pittman goes in short. Eccles.
Smart player, Eccles. You just saw the way he ran towards Pittman and then ducked back as soon as he knew he was going to receive and dropped into some space and finished with a footy himself.
Former captain of the Preston Knights.
And some chance from here. Pretty big kick.
But against a slight breeze. Now, McLeod, I don't know whether he's indisposed at the moment. He just applied that very effective tackle. I'll have some news on that in a minute. Oh, that's a terrible kick. Could have done a lot better with that. They still might get something out of it. Costa, Jamison, all tripped up, truly.
And 50.
And 50 metres as well. I must admit, I didn't see what the 50 metres was for.
Well, if you trip by hand, Peter, it's an automatic charge, 50 metres. So whilst it was a desperate performance,
it paid off for the price.
Yeah.
He's been good, Jamison. He's kicked two. This could be his third goal. And the move of Keating off the ground and Pittman at centre half forward has already worked for Malcolm Blight.
He's still running the show from the bench here, Curls, isn't he?
He's the best Will Curley. He's just too good.
Now let's see. Yep. by hand. Took a decent off divot too. Jamieson kicks his third. So Jamieson at one end and Ben Holland at the other, getting plenty of the footy. Holland's kicked 2-1, including a poster. Jamieson three straight.
Well, Doug, this is a pretty good game of footy. It's a great start by the Tigers, but in such hot conditions, it's going to be tough for both sides to keep it going at this rate.
Yeah, certainly do, no doubt about that. And Sean Wren in the last 3 or 4 minutes got a couple of very important possessions.
What a start to Jamieson.
Malcolm Blight put Ellen up forward in the grand final. Today he's got Jamieson there doing the job.
He's also got Mark Rusciuto at full forward right now.
Gale.
Eccles in the middle.
Eccles, he'll be keen to make amends for that bad kick before, but it's smart. Lovely run. Lovely ball. From 60 metres out. Could have done better. No one crumbing except Callaway. But deep in the Crows attacking area, Rogers overruns it. Costa confronted too high. Might get a free kick. He will get a free kick. Curls.
Yeah, this opening by Richmond does not surprise me at all. The tension and the enthusiasm in the room before the game was very, very high, and I thought that'd come out very strong.
Leaders on. Bond taken down in the tackle. Play on call. James likewise taken down in the tackle. Ben Gale, smart's got him. Has another dip at him. James, handball. Connell, has he kicked it? Yes. Point of numbers.
Jeez, it was a good get, Connell. He looks so much like a number of other players out there. But you picked him in one, and it's Dougie, I think the difference has been that a number of key players for the Crows have lifted their work rate.
Yeah, no doubt. Wren, Nigel Smart coming down the ground, as we said before, playing 150 game. He come down the ground, his tackle on Ben Gale certainly got the ball to come loose, and great goal there by Connell.
Well, I'll tell you what, they don't intend running a marathon here because they've opened like Oakley Platers, haven't they? 4-2 to 4-1. And under these conditions, Curl said it was hot. It's going to be a survival of the fittest here this afternoon. Harrison out to Campbell. Oh, gee, that's a towering kick. Richardson at the back. Couldn't complete the mark. Little toe poke out there by Bassett. Daffy. He's content to take it over. And a breather.
Well, Prescott started in the middle for that centre bounce, but Jeff Geeshan has now just effected a change, and he's got Prescott to go all the way with Rusciuto. Dan playing now at fullback, and Callaway just at the moment working his way up into the midfield.
Evans coming from what was then the VFA, now the VFL in Springvale, does look pretty tough.
Wayne Campbell's lifted his work rate too. He's had about 9 or 10 possessions. Started the game very slowly.
Who's he? Back pocket or halfback?
Yeah, he's playing on the wing, I think. Been picked up by James R. Tyson.
Out of bounds again. So they will be content to take a little bit of a breather. 26 to 25. And we've got under 2 minutes left in the first quarter. A crackerjack affair here at Footy Park. Ran over the top. Daffy overruns it. Bickley did the hard work, tries to get it to a teammate. Connell kicks it across his body. Gale couldn't complete the mark. Rogers taken down. There's a free kick here. Going to Rogers. Rogers at right centre wing. Holland again in the front. Bowden confronted. Jarman's got him. Crowd wants holding the ball.
Handball.
Jarman again. He's ridden into the ground. They've put the whistles away. Harrison. He'll give it to Gale. No, he won't. He's gone further back to Rogers. Mungrel punt off the boot. Smart in front. Richardson nearly took a screamer. McLeod. Hart. Hart from halfback. Up towards centre field.
That's just great skill. Being able to pinpoint a player coming out of the fence like that was brilliant.
He had strong hands though, didn't he? Prescott gets back quickly. Confronted. Gaspar tries to brush the tackle. Prescott again from Campbell. And the mark taken by Tawney on centre wing. Game at breakneck speed. That side would love another goal before the quarter time siren, which isn't too far away. Benny Gale gets it out to Harrison. Powell. A little give to Bowden. Bends that one back, but not enough. That might be out on the full. It is.
And Brendan Gale's done very well, picking up six possessions to date. The Tigers are looking for him, just trying to make Sean Wren more accountable. So Sean Wren hasn't been able to play that loose man through the middle of the ground. He's got a man he's got to worry about.
Bassett to bring the ball back. Gale. Oh, right on the side. He'll have a shot.
Torby or drop punt here, Doug?
I reckon drop punt. The bloke, he can kick the ball, Jed, as we all know. Benny Gowing, there's no doubt he's on top of Schwimmer at this stage of the game. And, well, Jared, would you kick the top or you go the drop punt maybe?
Well, I couldn't have ever made even half the distance with a drop punt. So
on the same boat.
Throw the torp in and hope for the best.
Kick a big mungle torp, have a crack at it.
Well, one thing in his favour, he's got whatever breeze there is at his back. He's also got the sun at his back. It's not a good thing, but... So Brendan Gale from about 53 metres. Plenty of tall throws back in the goal square, but they're not needed. It's off the side of the boot. No further score in the first quarter, and he's not happy.
And with the drop punt going like Dougie said, I knew I should have tried it to him.
Oh, always good to be wise after the event. A much closer game than the one last year, late in the season, at quarter time at Footy Park. Adelaide 4-2-26, leading Richmond 4-1. Gale and Wren had a great battle in the first quarter, with honours probably going to Benny Gale. The ball is shuffled at the McLeod at left centre wing. Kicks across his body down towards left half forward. Chance for Gasper. Kicks to a contest on centre wing now. Connell measures the kick. Back to Wren. Off a step, stands and delivers up towards centre half forward. Jarman just a little bit of a push. Five kicks in the first quarter. Jamison, oh, how easy is that? Well, he made it look easy, didn't he?
Well, he's one of the most talented players that there is going around. And Jamison knew that if he could just wait, hold his lead up, and then find some space, he was going to get the ball out in a position where he could take an easy mark. Jason Dunstall said he was the best player he ever had delivering the ball to him. And I reckon every full forward would be delighted to have him in the team.
Jamison's kick. Oh, he's got another one. That's four.
Well, Doug, I don't think you could blame Scotty Turner for that one. The disposal was perfect. Carl Lewis couldn't have intercepted that.
Yeah, not you. Dead right there, Jared. The lead was very good too. He dummied the lead and then ducked back to his left-hand side. And once again, Sean Wren's got a couple of quick touches in the start of this second quarter. It's very important. And McLeod as well is a great player too.
And Ricciuto's shuffle out at that first centre bounce was fantastic. And they're the important possessions.
Four goals to Rod Jamison. Brian Sheehan puts it down again. Well, the Crows getting it out of the centre. McLeod to half forward. Chad Rintoul. Too far off the score. Kicked into the man on the mark. Tawney. Will they pay the ultimate price? Oh, Powell! What a mark! Terrific grab. Daffy.
Oh, shot kick.
Well, there's a kicking letting them down both sides at the moment. Wren.
Well, this is one of the problems with Daffy's game. He does just throw the ball on the boot at times. It works for him often, but he should have hit a target with that one.
Connell to Jarman to McLeod. Well, a worm burner that one. Knight's intercepting. Costa, Jamison. Oh, terrible hand pass intended for Rintoul. They might get out of this, Richmond. Turner. They will get out of it to Michael Gale. Well, a couple of... But it might prove very costly turnovers there from both sides. Wren, another turnover.
Beautiful.
No, he can't do that. It's got to come back.
Why can't you do that, Doug?
Because umpire Brian Sheehan said he couldn't.
Fair enough. Generally, that's good enough. You may have called time on. That would be the only reason I think that that brilliant handball was disallowed.
Shame for Adelaide fans. Sean Wren can kick long. He'll do that again. Jamieson in front. Off the ground. And that was from Johnson. What's he done? One behind. Let's go to curls.
Yes, a very interesting move here by Malcolm Blight. Caven, who's been a very good centre-half back last year and this year, has been taken off. And Orman Allen has gone on to Evans there. That's an interesting one.
Well, they're both pretty tough. We've got that in common. Could be a pretty interesting matchup, that. Wren jostling with Gale. Ricciuto went without it. Costa didn't. Oh, lovely evasion. Kicks from 49 metres. Costa into the goal square. Eccles was pushed out. Turner's got the mark. That was a decent old shove from Scotty Turner, who decides to take him on again. And well done. Beautifully delivered. Harrison.
They're struggling up to centre forward there, Gerard. No doubt, Richmond. They've got no one up to centre forward. Maybe Holland may have to come at the ground.
Bowden, nearly. And nearly out of bounds. Good buck by Tawney. Campbell, smart. Tries to get it past Bowden. Tawney's there. Rintoul intercepting again. Gee, we've seen some turnovers at the start of this quarter. And the mark is taken by Bond.
Well, Bowden just gave that one away. He obviously handballed to the voice, but the voice had a crow's jumper.
Bond, gee, that's not a bad sort of a roost. Oh, Eccles. Costa should kick a goal. No, he can't. Jamieson again, can he get his 50? Can't. That's out of bounds.
Great to see some desperate football by both teams.
Oh, what a match.
The Tigers on their last line have just orchestrated a fantastic save.
He nearly brought that down.
Darren Bennett would have been pleased with that hang time.
He would have. Bond. Tyson. Rogers has just about got him. Still Tyson. Went down hard in the tackle. Knights beautifully done from the Richmond skipper. Gale. With a bit of run. To get around Wren. Oh, Wren's nearly got him. Great tackle. Duncan Callaway. Out of bounds on the four. It's all pressure, Jared, isn't it?
Well, I think that after a slow start in that department, the Crows have responded on their home ground, and the Tigers certainly haven't shrunk back either. They're going at it pretty hard. We're going to have a very good game of footy.
James to Pittman.
I think you're right, though, Doug. The Tigers just struggling on that half forward line. Can't penetrate into their attacking zone.
Harrison missed it. Bond. Eccles, Turner. Knights. Eccles nearly had him. Well, James overran it. Gets a second chance. Off the side of the boot to Richmond. Scotty Turner on his own. One of the real tough nuts in Tigerland. That's a good kick. That's been the exception rather than the rule in this quarter, though.
But he's had to come down almost to half that flank to get a possession.
Power from Richardson.
No one had a kick.
Oh, gee, another bad kick. Bumped by Mark Bickley on the ring, but they both felt that.
And he's the first change in Jeff Geeshan's restructuring of this forward line, bringing Miranda onto the ground, though.
They had a bit of pace around their forward line there, Jared. I'd still like to see Knight come back up into the midfield or maybe drag Costa into the Richmond forward line.
Chance for the Crows, picked up by Ormond Allen.
Great.
Oh, that's a mark.
Oh, what?
Penny Gyle asks the question, and so do I. Oh. Says no play on. Connell, goal kicker in the first quarter. Evans gets up to stand the mark.
Well, the mongrel punt's certainly been on display here in this last 15 minutes.
It has.
That's all due to the pressure, I think, from both sides in the middle.
Pittman, nearly. Campbell. Well, pressure again. Kicked into the man straight in front of him. That's just about out of bounds. It is out of bounds from Connell.
Well, I haven't seen the Woomer banger used in football for a long time, but the Ron Barassi inverted screw punt was on display there.
Is it the condition of the ground, this sand, that's causing that?
I don't think so. It wasn't affecting the game of the first quarter. I think it's just the pressure.
James to Wren. Gale runs straight into a tackle. Grant wants a hold in the ball position. There is a free kick. It's going the other way. Too high, I guess.
And paid by the umpire, who wasn't in control of the match. Right. Sheehan was the central umpire. Been overruled.
Is that Humphrey Smith down there, Joe?
I think it is the hyphen.
Yeah, Humphrey Smith.
Harrison. Kicks it the half forward. It's as far as it's going. Good block down there by Nathan Bassett from Norwood.
Morinda's gone to full forward. He's gone with Smart. And I reckon Jeff Geeshan would be pretty pleased to have Smart away from the half back line.
Smart's been giving them a lot of drive there, hasn't he? James, a little fumble. Tried to get it out to Hart. James gets it back again. That's a good kick. Plenty of distance with it. Kellaway in front. Opposite number three, Jarman. Dives on top of it. Still Kellaway. Gasper. Good Shepherd. Enables him to affect the hand pass. Campbell. Equally long hand pass to Michael Gale. Michael Gale at right half forward. Eccles can't catch him. Puts it up high. Wrenchard punch and does. Ball hits the deck. Scooped out by Holland. Nearly a throw. Heard one of that. McLeod. James running with him. He's got a couple of options. Decides to go longer. Kicks up towards Prosciutto. Can't complete the mark. Prescott there. So to Costa. That will be a free kick.
What about the skill of Andrew McLeod? Generally, the great ball players can run at full flight with the hands along the ground. Not too many of them, I might add, but the likes of Alex Jezelenko is a great ball controller. Darryl Bulldog, those brilliant
Kevin Bartlett
boys, the guys that have got the ball on a string can do that.
Costa's kick, ineffective as it turned out. Jamison, their main target, having to give chase, but he's not going to get a kick here. It goes to Michael Gale. Michael Gale at right half back. Great vision. Evans to right half forward. Duncan Kellaway, the two number threes. Jarman cannons it to Harrison. Jarman down, but gets up pretty quickly. Marking contest at full forward. Bickley, a quick kick. Doesn't clear the danger zone. Pass Johnson. Chance for Wren. Smart, beautifully done. Great touch. He's in terrific form. Smart from halfback. He runs again. Puts the Crows deep into attack via Eccles. The hand pass. Back to Smart. Left-hand handball onto Johnson. Eccles goes at goal. Deserves a goal. At the post! The climax, not what they would have wanted.
Great play there by Smart. He just come down to the ground and, as you said before, Jared, they've been forced to play him back and deep into the Adelaide defence with Morinda coming onto the ground, but he just kept coming and coming. Morinda did give chase, but just couldn't keep up.
He's a brilliant player, Smart.
Neil Curley says he might be a little bit tender at the moment for Adelaide. Let's hope that isn't the case. This is a good duel between Kellaway and Jarman. Certainly one of the... well, one of the duels of the day. Jarman, just looking at his stats, he had five kicks in the first quarter, but he hasn't been a goal kicker yet, which is perhaps surprising. Richmond can get a goal here through Evans. 25 metres out and closing, he kicks it.
I think his Richmond teammates in the goals could be very, very happy that goal went through there. I just thought maybe there's a handball over the top to the two Richmond players. I think one was Holland and the other one could have been Richardson. So, but anyway, the choice was good. Evans kicked the goal, so well done to him. But the handball certainly was on.
Yeah, nice bit of work there also by Ben Harrison to mop up. Good tackle on McLeod, created the goal.
So Brett Evans, who played in the Richmond Reserves Premiership side last year, getting the goal for the Tigers and reducing Adelaide's lead to just 3 points now early in the second quarter. Campbell overruns it. Kellaway, as I said, great deal with Jarman. Bassett, and what a find this young man is. On the McLeod, who's got a paddock to move in. No mark to Pittman. Kellaway again, the Knights. Daffy.
It's a better kick from Daffy.
It is. That's beautiful kick, beautifully delivered to Richardson. Player on his own is Holland, who found some space at the corresponding time of the first quarter to kick two goals, one. And he may start off the second term again by putting Richmond once again back in the lead.
Looks a lot more comfortable, Matthew Richardson, up the ground out of that goal square where he can run Bassett around, and he's had two or three very important touches over the last couple of minutes.
Thank you. against the slight breeze. Ben Hobbin for his third. And off the hands for a rush behind. Behind are the Tigers. The difference is back to 2 points, 5-4 to 5-2. Norman Dallin. Got a bit of a blonde rinse in the hair. He was more red last year, wasn't he? Wren, good hand pass. James has been busy. Kick could have been a little bit better weighted. It was intended for James Tyson, who played 7 games with Richmond back in the 1993 season.
The Tigers have given away the match-up at full-back. Scotty Turner's just now a loose man, and Callaway has gone on to Jamieson.
Connell.
That's a Callaway.
Rogers. That's a throw. And he's bending for it. Well, he just had to keep it on the ground, Jared, didn't he?
Well, it's an interesting one, but when you scoop the ball, you generally give the umpire no other option than to give the call of throw. And I think, Dougie, that was probably fair enough.
Yeah, good call. I think the decision there, Jared, was spot on. Should have punched the ball then.
Yep.
Ricciuto gets the goal. And in the context of this game, that was a pretty costly decision to go against the Tigers.
Well, it was a fair decision, though, and unfortunately you've got to take the good with the bad, but it's those little errors of an unprofessional error. That was an unforced error, if you like, if you're calling a tennis, Peter, and you've just got to get those out of the team's game in total, Doug.
Well, no doubt they're good. Should have punched the ball, as we said before. You've got to punch the ball in that situation.
I think the fact that he lofted it, had he kept it along the ground, it probably wouldn't have been free kick. Now we have a centre square infringement, and it's going to Richmond. Benny Gale. Unforgivable. But he went like that. Holland to fire again. Smart. Crumbs the better for Adelaide. The two number threes again, Callaway and Jarman. Michael Gale. It's around Johnson. A bad kick. Bassett.
Cloud has just rebuilt his Bassett.
Connell. Oh, it's a hospital job. Benny Gale getting the free kick. Now gets the order to play on from the umpire. Lovely severing kick to Richardson. Subtle factor. Powell read it well. So the Tigers may be able to get the quick reply. This is the most difficult pocket at Football Park, so the experts tell me from which to kick a goal.
To go to the banana or a boomerang, Doug, would you?
I
trust the drop punt.
I think Jared made the drop punt from there.
Runs around, kicks, close, misses.
Supposed to be a bit tough to do a boomerang with if you're a left footer.
Well, maybe the what they call it, the boomerang, the check sign or the screw kick.
Yeah, if you're a right footer.
Hart.
Sorry, Robert.
Confused everybody. Wren, simply too tall. Holland did well.
It's a good battle though between Wren and Gale.
Coddle. Plenty of possessions, kicked a great snap goal in the first quarter, Ricciuto. Johnson. Well, this Crummer's waiting for the ball to hit the deck. Daffy kick. Jarman. Too far out to score. Darren Jarman hasn't scored a goal today.
Nick Daffy's got to look at when he gets the footy. He just seems to kick the ball blindly. Doesn't give his teammates any chance.
They might have a chance here. Tyson snaps, but registers only one behind.
And I think in all fairness too, Jared, I mean, you are in the back line. You're under enormous pressure. Sometimes the option is to kick it out long, but as well, I think you should look for it up the ground, look to your teammate as well.
Yeah, it's vital to maintain possession. I think that's a modern-day law of footy. No point clearing the space if the ball just comes back straight back over your head.
Michael Gale from Turner's kick in. Killed away to Daffy. Evans. Crumbs it well. Ormond Allen.
He read that one well. He was a couple of steps in front of his direct opponent. In Harrison.
And to Johnson. Almost a look-alike. Pittman. Needs to get it to James and does. James has been busy at right half forward. Evans closing. Not a great kick. And the mark is taken down here for the Tigers by Andrew Kellaway, playing out the second game. Runner-up in the Tigers' best and fairest last year. Reserves best and fairest. Well, mark, free kick, whatever. And he had his ponytail removed. Michael Gale. To Benny Gale. The brothers share it around. Prescott. Smart. Richardson. Duncan Kellaway. McLeod, the Norm Smith medalist. Bassett. Crows defence standing up well under pressure. Tyson. Tyson marks in a wing. Now Jarman. Love to watch this fellow with the football. Still Jarman. Doesn't cap it off there with a goal. Went so very close, but only one behind. In fact, Jarman's first score of the day.
Starting to work up into that forward zone though, starting to become a little bit more dangerous. Has created one already in this term with his pass to Jamieson. Inside the forward 50, no more dangerous player.
Campbell, actually Blurton in the meantime coming on for Richmond. He's on his own at midfield too, Blurton. If Campbell sees him, he hasn't. Ormond Allen took off like a 707. It was a free kick, the advantage paid. There's Blurton. From Duncan Callaway's hand pass. Harrison. Claim. Richardson. Ben Hart. Ricciuto. James. They're running in numbers out of defence. This is Connell. Connell from short of left centre wing. Big pack of players. Gasper was there. Knights comes it well. Will he give it to Rogers? Now he goes to Campbell. Probably that option may have been better. McLeod, always busy. Not a great kick, collision time. Ball hits the deck, Evans went past without it, Rogers didn't. Blurton, first touch of the day. Had a meal of the mark. Didn't matter, as it turned out, back to Campbell.
Tyson off for Chad Wintour, coming on for the Crows.
Miranda, yes, no, smart, missed it. Knights. You give it to Harrison. Harrison in the pocket.
Richardson at the back.
Sit. Can't mark. Well done from Hart. Richardson has to beat two snaps. Close, but not close enough. Ball still in play. Ormond Allen takes the mark.
We've got the loose players here. The Crows have got another one up the middle. And that's the way they like to play. Keep it wide and then just spear the long ball into a leading forward.
James to Rintoul. Rintoul to half court, Blurton.
And that turnover would be making the coach pretty incensed, you reckon?
Wood, Daffy. Benny Gale. He worked so hard to get it up there, Blurton. Well, he hasn't had a man since he's come on, and he's had three possessions. Richardson, too far out to score. He's kicking three quarters from goal from there. Powell, nearly. Oh, Ricciuto, taken high. Bickley. Johnson around Campbell. Kicks to right half forward. Rogers, Bond, Daffy, McLeod. They're all having a dip. Bond wins with speed. It's taken in the back. Free kick. Obvious enough.
Interestingly though, Dougie, when Johnson got that ball across the half back line, he turned to look for the support runner. And Ormond Allen hadn't left the blocks. And I reckon that that's the sort of thing that Malcolm Blight would be focusing on at half time. That whilst they're playing quite well, they haven't got this game in their control by any means, and they're not just getting enough run as they have done through the last 12 months.
Vaughan's kick into the goal square. Jamieson off the ground, I think touched.
He might have been a desperate lunge from Scotty Turner that saved that goal, but...
Let's see who did touch it. Colin Poe, very quick to indicate it was touched.
I think it's about time now Matthew Knight's come out of that back line and just went and got the football. He's only had about five or six possessions so far. Costa's doing the job on him, so I think Jeff Gershon should bring him up onto the ball, maybe into the forward line.
Oh, Connell, courageous attempt to mark, not paid. Tyson.
Good tackle.
Comes down to Tawney. The ball to be won on centre wing. And the kick off the ground out of bounds. It came from Ashley Burton, who now has an opponent.
That was a great, fantastic tackle there by Tawney. Fingertip job, but just enough to keep the Tigers in the game.
That opponent is Connell, who goes at Lurton. That's going to be holding the ball nearly, but not quite. A minute and a half before half-time. 6-7 to 5-3 in favour of Adelaide. They've worked hard for a 10-point lead. Men in white. They might be working a bit of a sweat today, too. Connell. Short kick, Burton again. He's done well since he's come on. Good defence, Ormond Allen. The educated twist to the boundary line. So throw in. Right half forward for Richmond. Big chance for Richmond to come within a kick. The Tigers can get a goal via this forward thrust. Campbell did the ruck work. Kellaway and Johnson. There's Duncan Kellaway. Holding the ball. And the advantage is paid, so Campbell goes at goal. Miranda, smart, still Miranda. Richardson will bend it back. The snapshot, the bounce is going to be effective. Ormond Allen snares it just inside. Proctor down there, he's just come onto the ground as well. Rogers, great attempt to mark. McLeod confronted. Bond, Daffy out of bounds. And Richmond making another change. Bowden is going to come back on.
Harrison off.
And the locals are incensed by this one. And it's easy to see why. It was clearly, you could say, that was a handball.
Maybe with the high tackle too there, the way it looked.
Galen Wren. And the clock ticking down to just a few seconds. Richmond needs a mark here. Holland, can he give them a goal? He's kicked a couple already. A one-on-one duel. Punch away by Ormond Allen again. Campbell takes the hand pass from Bowden. Back to Bowden on the left.
Oh.
Slews off the side of the boot. Blurton, as the siren goes to end two action-packed quarters of football here. What a game this has been. I said earlier, Jared and Hawk, that it's going to be a survival of the fittest, and it really is, isn't it?
Well, I think both sides, Doug, have worked very, very hard across the ground, but neither side has got their forward line set up perfectly to make the most of their opportunities. Just Ormond Allen there, you have to admire him coming from Melbourne last year, a little bit stiff to miss out in the grand final side, but he really has made a footballer of himself over the last 18 months or so. But the game's set up for a big second half.
Yeah, certainly, and Blighty has a big rap for Ormond Allen, certainly bringing him back into the side. I just felt that Richmond midfield started to slow down a bit, particularly with Knights playing in defence. I think it's very important he comes now up to the midfield to give him a chop out there.
All right, so at half-time, the Crows leading Richmond by 10 points, 6-7 to 5-3. Back at Footy Park in a moment.
Dressed up with nowhere to go? Why not get undressed with us at the 5-star hotel, Australia's premier phone sex and personal contact hotline? Simply call 1-900-111-800 and choose from hundreds of recorded messages from like-minded girls who want to meet you. It's discreet and it's complete. It's the 5-star hotel for that extra service you deserve. Call 1-900-111-800 now.
Mark Harvey made one of the biggest impacts any youngster could ever dream of when he burst into the VFL in 1984. Courageous and cocky, he became an integral part of Essendon's success, sparking the side when needed. They never came much tougher, pound for pound. Harvey was respected by every opponent and to this day is held in the highest esteem by coach Kevin Sheedy, who now has Harvey by his side in a coaching role at Windy Hill. The blonde-headed youngster recruited from Keilor took on and beat many players much bigger and physically stronger than he, but they often came off second best. In the twilight of his career, he became the general of the Bomber backline, won a club best and fairest and played in 3 day and 3 night premiership sides, gained state selection, and also named All-Australian on a halfback flank. Now Mark Harvey joins our champion team as a commentator and host on the exclusive Football Channel Sports AFL.
From the makers of some of the world's finest documentaries comes a channel unsurpassed in real-life entertainment.
But only if you promise to marry me.
Come with us on a wondrous journey through time and space, through diverse cultures and faraway places. Explore the animal kingdom and unravel the secrets of life.
We've rediscovered the wheel. Isn't science wonderful?
Experience the journey on Channel 5 of your Optus Vision. Odyssey. Team Championship. 8 teams boasting some of the game's biggest names, putting it on the line for their country. Catch the semi-final action from 4 p.m. Sunday on ESPN.
It's up for grabs this game still, but I still favour the Crows at this stage.
Well, Dougie, you've got your wish. Obviously, Jeff Geeshan has been listening to you. Matthew Knight's in the centre, and let's see if he can do some damage.
Yes, with Costa, Rogers, a quick kick. Bowden, they'd like to get more out of him too, Jared, wouldn't they?
Struggled a little bit, along with Richo. They're the two players and Knights that they need to lift the Tigers.
Ormondale off the ground to Cottle, who's been certainly one of Adelaide's stars today on the stat sheet. Well, how did Jarman get clear there? Did Callaway fall over?
Yeah, he slipped over there, Peter, no doubt.
About the only way he'd get that much space, wouldn't he?
Lost his feet.
Not even sure this kick was meant for him. But
I don't think it was, Jared.
He was in the right spot at the right time, and geez, he does that a few times.
Oh, and he'll kick this too.
Well, against that, he's against the breeze.
Oh, good mark. And that breeze is starting to lift a little bit. Yep. Interesting, the bench for the Tigers includes Harrison, Powell and Miranda coming into this third term. So Harrison, obviously, not sure if he's injured. We might get Neil Curley to check that because he dominated the first term so much.
Turner to Rogers to McLeod. Back it comes again. Jarman once more. That was intended for him. On the lead, Jamison, who started the match well. He's kicked 4 goals so far into the forward pocket. Is that a push in the back to Bond? I think so. Very difficult shot.
Now, Dougie, would you go with the boomerang or the drop punt?
No, we did this before.
Well, Jared, I'd go the boomerang. I'd go the check side here. He's a right footer.
What about you, Neil Curley? Would you go the boomerang here? You've had a lot more experience at this ground than anyone else. Well,
he's gone to sleep, I think.
Silence is deafening.
Well, he did tell me that it is a difficult pocket from which to kick goals. That's not a bad sort of an effort, but I don't think it's going to get the bickies. Pittman has got the mark. There's a push out. It's going to be a free kick to Richmond.
We saw the way the ball just bent away from the goals there. I think the only way you could possibly get it to come back on the wind or against the wind may well be with the boomerang. Mm. But we got a comment from the King shortly.
I think he's gone to check on Harrison's situation there, Jared.
Turner kicks in, Connell. Now he is too far out to score. Bowden on the mark. Goes in short. Terrible kick, Tawney. Might have been intended for Pittman, but gee, that was a bad kick. Evans, Ormondale, good mark. And give it to Prescott. Prescott, forward of half-back, Benny Gale. On the stat sheet at half-time, I noticed he and Wren, stats were just about the same. Pretty good balance there. Blurton had 5 possessions when he came on in timeout in the second quarter. Bassett.
Did very well. It's pretty predictable the way that the Richmond was structuring that forward assault. But Bassett's just a young player and doing particularly well again.
He has he had a pretty good season so far. Tawny late. Now, how late was that? Not late enough on Connell to warrant a 50-metre penalty, obviously. So play seesawing between half-back and half-forward at the respective sides at the moment. Cavaway's kick up and under. It's going to be a foot race here. Knights starting at the centre circle. They need more out of him and this guy, Bowden. Missed what he should have taken, Richardson. Then applies a tackle. Arguably could have been in the back, though.
Well, Neil, we've been trying to make a case for the Czech side at the other end, and what about Ben Harrison?
Yeah, well, he's about to come back on now. The medical staff assured me he was okay, and he's about to make a change with him now.
Thanks, Pearls.
Obviously doesn't like the boomerang.
I reckon Harrison's going to go forward.
Bickley wrapped up pretty quickly. Now, Rashuto ducked his head and had the ball held to him, so... ball-up decision, probably the right one there. No addition to the half-time score here at Football Park. Still 43 plays, 33, 10 points in favour of the home side. Well, Holland takes out Wren. Oh, gee. Campbell, dispossessed. Rogers. Centering kick from him. All Crows, waiting down Evans, snaps. Not bad. Hit the post.
Well, that was an astonishing lack of a decision by the central umpire there. Well, it looked as if Benny Holland just grabbed Sean Wren from behind.
Oh, he did. So Bassett looking for lead to cross half back. Now gets the whistle from the umpire. Brings it out this side of the ground. Sean Wren the target. He doesn't let him down. Terrific duel, he and Gale. And certainly, statistically speaking, the honours are even at the moment. Wren's kick towards centre wing. No high taker. That is too high against Michael Gale. And Johnson will take the free kick at right centre wing.
Looks like Richardson coming off and Harrison going the full forward this stage for Richmond.
Harrison starting in defence today was a little bit of a surprise. Did well, got a lot of possessions in the first quarter. Pittman, nearly the mark. Bickley goes in solidly, as does Knight. The two skippers figuring in the action. Costa had it, lost it. Prescott, good tackle from Costa. Blurton off the ground, did well late in the second quarter. Gets it to Gale, and that was well done. Look away, hand pass, Duncan Callaway. Up went Michael Gale and missed it. Still Callaway, Blurton. Wren intercepting. Connell. Now Smart, who's running out of defence, was terrific in the first half. Rintoul, this should be a goal. Bond closing. The checks are there. Gerald Green's wish. And apparently Gerald was the same play.
Well, maybe he's learnt from the first crack he had, but geez, it was a great passage of play. All coming from an interception by David Pittman from an errant handball from the Tigers. They had control of the ball with Brendan Gale going into the midfield, and they just mucked around with it. They didn't go long into the forward line. They wanted to overpossess the ball, and they've given it up. And that's a dangerous start for the Tigers because the Crows are kicking against the wind.
And again, in the context of this game, a valuable one to start the third quarter. 6 minutes gone and just the... one major on the board. 15 points is the margin enjoyed by Adelaide, but not really too much in that. So a chance for Richmond. They swing into attack. Not for very long. Johnson again. Confronted by Rogers. James, who's been impressive today. Bickley dodges a tackle from Proctor, which was arguably high, but the umpire calls play on. Jamison playing for the free kick. Callaway underneath it. That's Andrew Callaway.
Andrew McLeod is injured. We saw him go down heavily in a tackle in the second term.
He's taken off now. And that's a big blow, isn't it?
No doubt.
We'll get Neil Curley to check on that injury there. Well, Pittman was blatantly pushed in the back. Costa. Tyson takes the hand pass, snaps. Turner will mark it again on the last line of defence.
It looked like he was three quarters off too.
Can't argue with that. Scotty Turner given the benefit of the doubt. And that breeze freshening all the time. Blurton.
Tigers really have to make a burst here, create something, get some goals on the board.
Well, they have the breeze at their back, don't they? Michael Gale. Norman Dallin and Evans. Harrison and Bassett. Bowden took the hand pass, but he was confronted by three or four opponents. Bassett again to James. Liked his game. Campbell and Tyson. Campbell playing the percentages. Tyson. Now, he paddles it further forward, but he kept it on the ground. Brian Sheehan penalised, I think it was Rogers in the second quarter, for a throw for a similar offence, as we see McLeod with the bandage on the knee, and that's not a good sign if you're a Crows supporter.
Next goal, very, very important for Richmond. They must get it. If Adelaide get it, I reckon it could be nearly all over, even this early stage of the third quarter.
It's the ice on the knee, of course. And bandage, Prosciutto. Tawney. Jarman. Rintoul spears the pass in towards full forward. It's all Richmond. Blurton will be able to tidy up. Tawney missed the mark. Rintoul again tried to get it to Tyson. The hand pass left a little bit to be desired.
And I don't know, Doug. You describe it as manure on the ground at the moment. Perhaps it's a little bit more sand mixed in with the fertiliser, but it does look as if it's making conditions pretty tough for the players out there to keep their feet.
Yeah, you're right there, Drew. A lot of players have fallen over. I mean, an easy passage to play. I mean, guys just running the footy and just losing their footing.
Is that dangerous? I mean, at Waverley, we saw a few years ago a couple of knee injuries result from something like that. Rogers to Knights.
I think that's a legend.
Allegedly, sorry, yes. Bassett, solid in defence. Bickley. Holland on the mark. Costa. Board of half-back out to Hart. Hart kicks towards half-court. Sun's certainly a factor in marking contest like that. None can take it. Smart tries to go off the ground. Bowden is there. Keeps the ball in play. Hooks it back towards Michael Gale, who marks on centre wing. Gives it to Knights. And again, Richmond up towards half-forward. Holland. Daffy. Munro punt off the boot. Terrible kick again to James. That's kick for kick. Wren and Gale. Wren this time. Nobody running for him. So it goes long. Rintoul in front of Blurton. To Bond. Long kick by Bond. Just inside 50. Pittman. Gasper. Now Prescott from Andrew Kettleway. Wren again. Oh, James, he's playing really well, James. Bickley. Can the Crows get another goal here? Ducks in if they get one, could be just about over. Rashuda to Smart. Deserves a goal. Smart snaps. It might be coming around a little bit too much. One behind, I think. Yes, it is.
Well, the faithful here thought that was a goal. From where we stood, Doug, if you just followed the line of the ball, it certainly looked like it was inside the goalpost, but the umpire was in the perfect position. I think it's fair to say it did an in-swinger late.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, Gerald, I don't know what the turnovers are, but Richmond, I'll tell you what, have turned the footy over in this third quarter, probably on a half a dozen times, which is very, very costly for them.
Turner to Michael Gale, just up from the back pocket. Gale kicks to centre wing, kicks to a contest. Andrew Kettleway. McLeod on the bench. Neil Curley, you might have some word for us.
Yeah, it's not a bad one, but it's not a good one either. It's a jarred knee, and they're just icing it up for some precaution, and we'll wait and see.
Thanks, girls. Powell coming back on. I think it might have been Tawney that went off. Jamison taking the hand pass to right half court. Rintoul grabbed by Bowden. And the latter trying to get it out. But back to Blurton. Free kick to Richmond. And Bowden the recipient. Michael Gale, both Gales doing well today.
Stephen McKee preparing to come on for his first crack at it.
Brotherly love, Benny Gale, not Rogers, Turner. Harrison. Proctor. Another turnover. James.
They're absolutely Bickley. Dominating now in the midfield. The throws.
You give it to Eccles. Smart. And again, I've liked his game as well. Gets rid of James with the dummy. Oh. And again. Well, turnovers, we've used it so often, but there's been so many, Jerry.
Oh. Yes, it's really been a breakdown across both forward lines as Ben Holland comes off the ground for Stephen McKee. Let's hope he has a successful crack. But the side that can get their forward line organised best is going to really go away with this game.
Duncan Kellaway to Powell. Oh, that's a good mark.
I'll tell you what, Doug.
Proctor.
Smart has been desperate to kick a goal all afternoon. I reckon in the final quarter he's going to penetrate.
Masciuto. And again we see Richmond breaking down across half-back. Eccles. Smart. Well, he has been...
best on the ground.
There he goes.
Knighty takes him on. Rintoul. That's a long bomb. That's a great kick. Rintoul's first. Well, Smart didn't kick the goal, but he set it up, didn't he?
I think Smart's by far the best player on the ground. He's just had an absolute scorcher of a game. He's on a pretty good player early in Joel Bowden, but he's taken him to the corners. And he's just playing like a midfielder across the half-back line.
Been
that
great.
Was a bomb, wasn't it, from Rintoul?
Two positions, four marks to Nigel Smart. He set that goal up. He didn't kick it. It was kicked by Chad Rintoul, but 22 points the difference is the bottom line. Knights. Foster can't catch him. Great mark over the top by Smart. Done by Smart. Hart.
Tyson on his own.
Eccles, sorry.
Former youngster, well, still a youngster, but formerly of the Preston Knights. Proctor, late on Johnson. Kane Johnson, to centre wing. Costa. Not much on short, maybe Eccles again. He'll go a little bit longer than that. One-on-one, Pittman. Great use of the body from Gaspar. Did well to mark that kick. I don't think it was, maybe it was intended for him, but gee, it left the boot awkwardly.
Yeah, it had a bit of top spin on it, therefore it dived, which really gave the man behind absolutely no chance, Duncan Kellaway. As you said, Pete, pretty good performance to mark that one.
Looks like Benny Gowan's gone into the full forward area, even though he's come up the ground now. Looks like Scotty Turner's gone into the ruck.
This is a hard shot. Aaron Jarman, who's played in premiership sides with both the Hawks and the Crows. Kicking from 50, almost a cross breeze. He needed to aim for the right goalpost. He's done that, but it's not coming back. In fact, it kept its line, strangely enough.
He's mystified.
So am I. Two behinds to Darren Jarman.
Doug, they've got to find some winners in the middle of the ground. They've got Matthew Knights taking the kick in. He has been moved into the centre, but they're just getting thrashed in there at the moment.
They certainly are, Jared, and even Matty Rogers is down a little bit on his foot from last week. Bowden's been up and down as well. They are, and Prescott, of course, has got that tagging job as well, so on the shooter. So the
McKee, I think, getting his first touch. Young 19-year-old ruckman from Myrtleford. Johnson and Daffy, that's out of bounds centre wing. The last 6 minutes of the third quarter. Vital 6 minutes for Richmond. You reckon the Tigers would need to be within a couple of goals at three-quarter time. Pretty untidy passage of play here. McKee tries to get it out. Now they can, Evans. Rintoul, a juggle. In the right place at the right time. Connell. Gee, his game's been impressive. Bickley, left half-back. Richardson preparing to come back on for Richmond. Bickley goes long. Turner, Pittman, Gaspar. Turner's got it. He's been solid. Now can they get something moving? This is where they've been breaking down the Tigers across half forward. Same thing's going to happen again. Ormond Allen, did he keep the ball in? Not according to the boundary umpire, but let's go down to Curls.
Yeah, Peter, I think the comment you made, Richmond would have to be, in my opinion, two or three goals ahead at three-quarter time to have a chance of winning this football match. It's been a very disappointing quarter for them, and I think their coach would have something very severely to say at three-quarter time.
Daffy off the ground and Richardson on. This is where Richo can really take the game by the scruff of the neck. He's got an opportunity to do that.
Well, Smart's taken it by the scruff of the neck all day. To Bickley, a little bit of a push there by Pittman, not enough to get a free kick. That's a terrible hand pass. Straight to Rintoul, Bond confronted. Blurton, another turnover. Rogers. Smart went for the Speggy, and Marinda stayed down, read it better. Now, distance shouldn't be a problem for him here with 4 minutes to go in the quarter. He's got that breeze, what there is of it.
Good judgment there by Marinda. Read the play brilliantly there. And once again, as you said, Peter Landy, turnovers. I mean, costly.
Well, this will bring them to within 17 points if Mark Marinda can kick it. First kick today for him. He's got it.
Well, it's the first goal in the third quarter. They probably have the assistance of a three-goal breeze, and I think Neil Curley assessed it pretty well. A couple of goals up would be the minimum required to be in a commanding position. They can always turn around with a blinding last quarter, of course. As we see another change, Ben Harrison off the ground and Ben Holland on for the Tigers, going to the centre-half back area.
First goal for the quarter for Richmond and first kick for Mark Marinda. 17 points the margin, so Richmond certainly on the scoreboard at least in with a chance. McKee loses out. They've got to get a couple more before three-quarter time, you'd reckon.
Oh,
wow. Umpire let it go. Bickley. Rashudo. This might be the quick reply.
If anybody for Adelaide was going to kick one from this distance into the wind, it'd be this bloke. We saw Chad Rintoul do it.
Not wasting any time. Getting a fingernail to it was Rintoul, the man you mentioned, but only one behind. Kicked by Mark Rashudo. One goal, one. He's kicked for the day. So an even three goals.
Matt Connell, Jared's one sort of play. You don't realise he gets so many touches here. He's had 20-odd kicks. I reckon he had one or two just quick ones there. I mean, unbelievable. 21 kicks. 7-7 marks as well.
And that's off the back of a very good performance last week when he was in the Crows' best players. Once again on the wing, getting a heap of possessions.
And just about a set play. Gasper. And Holland. Gale. Marinda gets back. Two kicks. Can he make it? Two goals. He can't. Evans should be able to go from there. Will he try to draw a man? Takes a player on. Just went for it. Lots of
pass.
Lots of fortune. It's marked by Richardson.
Yeah, that was the Tigers' best passage of play. Other than the lucky nature of that last kick, but at least they got the ball in there quickly. They got it out of their defensive area very smartly, and it came into a forward line that wasn't cluttered up with the likes of Sean Wren.
Richardson for his first goal of the day. I'd say he's got it, judging by the lack of noise behind the goal. Yes, he has.
Well, the Tigers are making this one at least competitive, Dave. Maybe another couple before three-quarter time. At least maybe one more.
They do need it, Jared. And young McKee's been good going into the ruck. And you know, his first game, of course, from Murdoch for Victoria. And Benny Gale's been a very good player now, as I said before, gone deep into the forward line for the Richmond team.
I was hoping you'd tell us what Brett Evans was thinking then, Dave.
Two late goals by Richmond have given the Tigers heart and hope.
Nigel Smart's gone into the forward line, as has Darren Gasper for the Tigers.
Wren beats McKee. Rogers. Gasper.
Play now on.
Advantage played. Here's McKee. First kick. Richmond mark. As he plays Richardson.
Play on.
I thought it was a mark. Richardson did too. Careful, Richard. Well, he wasn't careful enough. Bassett takes the free kick. You can't argue with the umpires.
Eccles.
What do you reckon about that, Doug? Are you allowed to give the umpires a serve when you've clearly taken a mark, or well, at least the replay suggested he had? Yeah. In the old days, you possibly could, but maybe the umpires aren't taking any lip anymore.
No, always give them a spray, Jared. You're allowed to give them a spray, but I just felt maybe there, Benny Gard may get a bit of hand in that one as well. But no, give him a cook. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well, Holland's kick got the ball deep into Richmond's attacking zone again. So a late flurry by Richmond in the third quarter. As Keating prepares to come back on for the Crows.
Jared, there's nothing worse when you think you're right. Mate, you've got to unload, don't you? Let them know.
Well, the umpire certainly reacted pretty swiftly then.
He did. Just as well he wasn't mic'd. Bickley.
Greg Williams would have given away 23 kicks a match.
Bounce favours Prescott in the end. He was prepared to wait for it to bounce. Eccles, quick hand pass to Costa. Can the Crows nail one before three-quarter time? Bond has it taken away by Blurton. Good defensive punch to get the ball out of bounds. Right half forward for Adelaide. Prescott off. And Shawn's going to have a rest.
Pretty handy player to have in reserve.
Pittman, smart. The whistle. It's going the Crows' way.
Dougie, what do you think?
Yeah, I thought Benny Gale made a touch there. Shoot. On that one there, that mark.
Bond, hard one here. Another check side, Jared. No.
Well, I reckon it's the kick of choice from that spot.
One behind.
Kick a check side.
It's the only one that'll work back out into the middle of the ground. But I reckon you're being a bit harsh on Richo, Doug.
You reckon it was a mark, Jared?
I reckon it could have been paid.
Yeah, it just looked like Gale playing in front of him there. May have had a bit of a touch as well.
The Knights last time went long. Oh. They got a goal from it. He's caught out in the ball. Well, 1-1. Remember during the last time he kicked long, got it to Gasper in the middle. They finished up getting a goal from it and decided this time to go short and pay the penalty.
Well, he's claiming he handballed to himself, and technically he certainly did, but I think I'm talking to John Russo a couple of times. The umpires are paying that as in possession, that little dinky chop out to yourself.
It's been great, Kim Costa, too, on Matthew Knight. Certainly cut him right out of the game, and he just loves those really hard tackles and real tough football. Good play, Costa.
Do you reckon Knighty would have been looking for the hole to bury himself in
there?
He'd
be snaky, wouldn't he?
That would be the worst thing to do in footy.
Costa gets the goal, almost on the three-quarter time siren. Maybe we can take another look at it. Let's see if he was hardly done by it.
Well, I think it's just a matter of a question of whether or not that is a handball or is it's still retaining possession. In fact, it didn't look as if he actually got the fist onto the ball, just dropped it out of the right hand. But an embarrassing scenario. Every player's been through it. Just got to get on with the business.
Well, John Russell sums it up by incorrect disposal, doesn't he?
Well, yeah, plenty of time to get rid of it, Peter. Yep. Don't worry about that.
So Keating slaps it down. Rogers. Ball hacked out to Johnson. And Johnson will be more than... Oh, he's smiling about down a hammy there, Johnson. A little bit of the twinge the way he pulled up there. Now with McLeod already off the ground.
I think Johnson's missed a couple of weeks. Neil, has Johnson just come back from a hammy?
No.
Bickley.
It might be.
Might be going out of the hammy. Oh, beautifully done. Bond can't get clear of Holland, though, right on the three-quarter time siren. Well, it was 10 points the difference at halftime. The Crows have extended their lead in that quarter despite the late flurry from Richmond. And Adelaide does have the advantage of a very, very slight breeze during the final quarter.
And despite a great start by the Tigers, they've just got such a balanced running side.
Keating against Benny Gale as we start the final quarter at Footy Park. Crows with the lead, but will it be enough? players around the ball, and once again we'll see a ball up.
And Darren Gasper's gone to centre half forward for Richmond, and I think it's the midfield that need to lift. You know, Rogers, Daffy, Campbell, the Knights really need to lift themselves here.
Well, they've brought Ben Harrison on to Mark Ricciuto to start in the middle once again. They need his drive from the middle.
Sean Wren having a little bit of a rest. Gale wins it. Tawney spins out of trouble and then almost into trouble. Now there's a whistle on play here. It's going to be an Adelaide free kick. Now that was given by the umpire behind the play, actually. It's going to be taken by Tyson.
Unbelievable.
And the kick has to be taken where the ball actually is in play. If it's closer to their goal than it otherwise would have been.
Greater advantage. Bassett. 6-3, he's taken 5 marks and a very solid defender. Oh, great mark by Jarman. Can he turn on a magical final quarter? He's hooked it. He may have hooked it a little bit too much, I think. Judging by the lack of crowd reaction, one behind it will be to Darren Jarman. So he's kicked 3 behinds for the day.
Just great body work there. He sort of pushes the opponent under the football and just judged it a lot better than about 5 other players in that contest.
Rogers to Duncan Callaway, Jarman's man. Gasper and Smart. Smart with a good hip and shoulder, taken out of the contest. Bowden applies a tackle. That was well done. Costa. Daffy. Good tackle again. And the ball up. Short of left half forward for Richmond. Kim Costa playing on Matty Knights. The last to get up. Harrison and Keating. Daffy across his body. Up and under kick. Ormond Allen, the only one to really go for it. Nothing on offer. At midfield, and he finds Wynn Tool. Chandleson had to wait, and that gives the opportunity to the Richmond defenders to again tie it up just outside 50. We'll see a ball up. Andrew Callaway, number 39, giving it back to the umpire, playing only his second game. Pittman. Palms it out nicely. Rintoul, Gale, snares it. Michael Gale, a little bit slow to get rid of it. Does well. Costa, box seat, good mark. Sun in his eyes and everything. Looks for Jamison. Breeze at his back. Couldn't kick that, surely. Goes in short. No mark taken. Crowd thought it might have been a free kick. The umpire lets it go. Daffy. Kicks to a contest. Bickley out, Bustle. Is that going to be 50? No, it's not. Rogers. It's gone in short. Out to Daffy, and that's out. Out being the operative word. Out of bounds on the full. So Smart, one of the better players for the Adelaide Crows today. At his back. Two Richmond players in front. One of them's come down with it. Harrison. Bassett missed it. Tawney didn't. Richardson and Ormond Allen. Ormond Allen would be more than content to see that over the boundary line. Difference 20 points. Breeze freshening all the time. The Tigers are going to stand up. Now's the time.
Well, I think they're doing particularly well in this opening couple of minutes. We've been here as players and as commentators hundreds of times, Doug. And you know that the spectators here that gather strong are just waiting for that first goal because they generally signals an avalanche. So if Richmond can prevent them getting an early one, maybe they can remain competitive right until the finish and pull off a remarkable victory.
Prescott on. And Tawney went off, I think it was, wasn't it, Curls?
Yes, there's a lot of tired players down here now too. And, you know, Richmond just have to do some smart things here.
Well, they can get a goal. Powell. at the back. Evans! No, that was so close. Richardson. That's a difficult pocket from which to kick a goal. He's given that a decent old try. The punches need to be effective from the Crows. Caven couldn't clear the zone. Daffy taken down in the tackle. Evans. Bassett taken down by Powell. Ball jarred free. Held to him, according to the umpire.
Well, having the feeling of cracked the Tigers anyway, that's one thing we know. We've seen these first 3 or 4 minutes of this last quarter. They're having a real good dip at this.
RHG, a red-hot go. Gasper, Bowden. Well, it'd be a miraculous goal if he kicks that. Ormond Allen. Smart play to rush it through from behind and give the Crows a chance to regroup. Well, Richmond have had a lot of the footy early in the last quarter, which has been going 5 minutes or thereabouts. Bassett. I like the game of this fellow too, James.
That's terrific,
particularly well. 15 and 8.
And so many of this type of player. Bond's another one. Rintoul. Dyson. Connell's had a great game.
Well, we'll give him a wrap and he'll kick it straight to the opposition. Gasper to Rogers. And Rogers has been good too. Bowden needs to lift. He can lift Richmond with a goal here. Goal umpire right underneath and he's put it through. Here come the Tigers.
And here comes Sean Wren. At the first sign of trouble, their key man comes back onto the ground. I'm not sure if it is in response to that goal, but he's a pretty fair player to come off the bench to in a time of trouble. This is a great goal, and Doug Joel Bowden hasn't had a great afternoon.
No, he hasn't, Joe, but that was just brilliant football by him. I was about to say before, is Sean Wren injured or what's he doing having a rest down there? Because certainly, if I was the coach of Adelaide, I'd run the ground.
Well, Michael Blight has decided to bring back Sean Wren, or he will be back shortly in response to that goal by Bowden. So just 13 points the difference now. Richmond won't go down without a fight. Rogers nearly intercepted that hand pass from Rusciuto, who goes again. All Richmond. Turner. Bond. Lurton. Nearly got him, but got the boundary line instead, so that was okay. Wren still on the sidelines.
Done a fair job, young Lurton, on Bond. So certainly cut him out of the game a fair bit.
Holland over the top. Lurton. Knights. Gale. Back to Ashley Lurton. Came on just before half-time. We've got five possessions. Bounces beautifully for Daffy. Richmond could just about pinch this match if they keep going in this vein. Richardson. Puts it out in front. Oh, yes, it'll be a mark.
Great kick.
It was a great kick, that, wasn't it?
Oh.
Pretty fair grab in the finish too by Gasper, but it was set up by a terrific centering pass by Matthew Richardson. And the Tigers are still competitive. They've got to convert, obviously, and this one needs to go through, but they brought that ball into the forward line, and their forward structure, Doug, just looks a bit more competitive at the moment.
Yeah, a lot better. Good move by Gershon to bring Gasper down there. Richardson lifting too, and that man in the back pocket, Ashley Blurton, the kick was very, very good, way out in front of Daffy there, so he could run on the ball. So good play from the back line of Blurton.
13 possessions. Blurton came on, as I said, just before half-time. Should kick it. Needs to kick it. And does kick it.
Well, that was a very good goal. I mean, Darren Gasper has been criticised over the years for his disposal, but I think people won't accept the fact that whilst he may have had a bit of a problem at the start of his career with his kicking, Doug, he's a very competitive, a very accurate kick these days, albeit having a slightly unusual style, but most reliable. And that was a great goal.
Nine individual goal kickers now for Richmond. The difference back to 7 points. They only have one multiple goal kicker, Ben Holland, with two. They looked the better side early in the final quarter. Daffy again. Bends it around towards right half forward. Richardson again. Big name Tiger player starting to find some form. Ormond Allen again with good defence to get it out of bounds. But the Crows, well, they're looking a little bit tired.
Well, Phil said at three-quarter time that danger lurked just around the corner because of their problems with injuries to running players.
It may prove to be the telling factor, Jared. Wren back onto the ground. Bowden has another goal.
Oh, they've got a sniff. They've got a sniff.
He's got it. They got more than a sniff. They've got a meal.
It's amazing how this game's turned around, Jared Hurley. Fair dinkum, like, at three-quarter time, I thought to myself, really, how far Adelaide here? And all of a sudden, only about, what, 7 or 8 minutes into the last quarter, Richmond have gone bang, 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 and they're right back in this game.
Well, they were never going to win it unless their stars stood up, and Joel Bowden's considered one of those, a very talented player, match winner. And, well, he's had a poor game, but he's had a great 10 minutes.
11 kicks by Joel Bowden.
Looks like Eccles has gone back onto Darren Gasper. Smart has gone into the forward line.
1 point the difference. Again, Richmond out of the centre. The Crows have stopped to a walk so far. Oh. Bowden again. Dare we say it? Will Richmond be in front after this kick? Richmond's up! And they will now! The big names, the cream, whatever you like, has come to the top.
As you said, Doug, they've got a sniff and... they can smell a very big victory here. This means their midfield will all start running again. And they've got blood the ball rule. Out of the centre so think, many times.
I think Jared the blood rule here with Nick Daffy.
Yep. So Richardson will have to wait to take the kick. We haven't yet seen who's going to come back on. Nobody lining up on the bench at the moment. Or did somebody come on that I didn't see?
They're just maybe waiting and assessing their opportunities. And it is Mark Miranda who's going to come on.
He wasn't quite ready, obviously.
Not well, moving too well, Miranda, is he really?
No, he's not. Though. Richardson looking for the all clear. A goal will put the Tigers in front. And he's got it. Richmond lead. Well,
wow, Peter Landy. There's 40,000 people here, Jordan and Peter, in absolute shock. And three callers up in the box here just going, what has happened here? Unbelievable.
Well, when you don't put a side away, Doug, you leave the stable door open, all of a sudden, you might get a surprise visitor.
It's amazing, isn't it, really? It is a big turnaround. Oh, I can't believe this.
Four goals in 8 minutes by Richmond, and the Tigers have pinched the lead. Can they pinch the match? Wren. But they're not getting it out of the centre, and they won't hear again. Campbell, Costa, Knight, Duncan Callaway. Campbell's kick smothered. Lurton confronted by the skipper. Powell. A better effort from the Crows there to try to get it away from Richmond, who did gain the initial possession after the bounce.
I think we're about to see 10 of the most intense minutes of footy that you'd like to see anywhere.
Gee, that's a decent old bandage.
It's going to be a great test of character here for the Adelaide Crows.
Wren and Gale. Campbell. Had it, lost it. Powell. Onto Harrison.
Tigers doing all the running at the moment.
Prescott got underneath it. So too did Rintoul. The Crows need something as a steadier. Gale on Hart. That looked like an almost illegal hand pass. Wren off a step. Jarman Shawley lost sight of the footy in the sun. Tyson. Off the ground. Jamison. That's what the Crows needed. Boy, what a steadier. His fifth goal. Difference again. I tell you what, a draw would be a good result. Not for the Texas, but
don't the crowd just love it, Jim, when they get that goal? They all go up as one.
They've been desperate for something to yell about in the last quarter. Douglas has been a barren field, but they're back in front, but the Tigers still in with a chance and they know it.
Adelaide back in front of Football Park, and you don't need me to tell you that.
Have a listen to the crowd here, the voice. Oh, have they found it?
Norman Ellen loose across the half back line for the Crows.
Gale, smothered by Costa. Topo by Rusciuto.
Jeez, he's tough and going willing in the clinches at the moment. Straight boots going, the odd fist having a crack at the footy.
No place for faint hearts.
Oh, now we're going to see a pack of 20 players around the footy. It's going to resemble rugby league, I reckon, the next 5 minutes. Looking for breaks on the outside to get a long kick clear.
Rusciuto couldn't take the tap. It's almost like a try. Off the ground, Ormond Allen. Jamison on the burst. Good little defensive prop to take it over by Ashley Blurton. Curls.
Peter, this is the stage of a game where you sort the wheat from the chaff. You really watch the players to stay behind the ball and do have a real red hot crack for their team.
Curls, who have Adelaide got on the bench at their disposal that's fit?
Keating is the only one available.
Well, not what you call the most mobile player. Now, the crowd asking for deliberate, but Blurton did it from about 25 metres away.
Tell you what, you do take your life in your own hands when you do that. It's an unbelievable risk.
Now, you won't mistake Nick Dappy. There's a free kick going Richmond's way here.
I think when you handball Jared about 15 or 20 metres, that's the only thing up your sleeve, I think. If you're a bit closer than that, you're in a bit of trouble.
Holland, Wren and Gale. A terrific duel. Neither can bring the mark down. Press got Ormond Allen. Sensational tackle, but not rewarded.
Well, he's reinvented himself since coming here to the Crows. Ormond Allen is as tough as nails, and he goes so hard at the foot. He's really bulked up in the weight room. That's just a great tackle.
Ormond Allen again. Knights, Costa, Power. This possessed him. Oh, flattened by Ormond Allen. Downfield, that'll be. Bring it back, Matty Connolly, you'll get 50.
I mean, I think the player's committed on that circumstance. He was half a yard after the kick. You've got to allow a player to continue through with his tackle or his bump, and it's that close.
Rogers kicks to a contest. Caven gives the Crows something. Rintoul, come away, good tackle. And it opens it up for Matty Knights. To Harrison. Gale running with him.
All the way.
Still Harrison, inside 50, long bomb, Wimbam, 3 minutes to goal.
Just a shade of lack of awareness by Chad Rintoul has seen a major turnover that has resulted in a big goal for the Tigers, and here it is.
Callaway again, Duncan.
Picked it up and watched the left footers combine. Smart decision is to go all the way. It's a one-on-one at the end of the day. If he kicks it long to a pack, he went all the way and did it beautifully.
A thriller at Footy Park, and it's hard to believe that these two sides were separated by 137 points when they met in round 17 last year. It's a little bit different today with the Tigers really finding some snarl under Jeff Geeshan.
Plenty of time for both teams here.
Yes, we've just passed the halfway mark of the last quarter. And Peter Vardy, who was KO'd in the first quarter, is going to come back on. Rusciuto, oh, good catch. And I call it a catch, not a mark, by Rintoul. Oh, terrible kick. Holland.
And 50.
50.
Yeah, it'd have to be 50, wouldn't it? No. A little bit lucky. He's off now. Smart's got him. Holding the footy.
Can he come behind?
That's a call play on him, Ken. Smart was just sweating on him. And he would have heard the call and then bang. And just a little bit of an experience there by Benny Holland. Has come up with a very dangerous free kick.
Well, he ducked the head. Sean Wren, dare I even mention that free kick. Vardy comes back on. He'll get a warm round of applause from the crowd.
Rintoul's been replaced after a bit of a lack of awareness and that poor kick.
Smart with a breeze at his back. Kicks and has missed, I think.
I'll tell you what, Malcolm Blight must be pretty snaky to take Rintoul off because Vardy hasn't played since he got that heavy knock.
Yeah.
Richmond by 4 points.
Tigers going into the huddle. The Crows going man-to-man.
Scotty Turner to the outer side. Duncan Callaway on the burst. Can't take the mark. Knights, Jarman, Harrison. Andrew Callaway takes it out in front of Bond for a throw-in. Crows right forward pocket. Adelaide needs a goal. 7 minutes, 41 seconds left in the contest. The crowd at Footy Park roaring themselves hoarse. Pittman at the back. Couldn't get a fingernail on it. Bond tripped up. Tries to get it to a teammate. Socket off the ground by Rogers. Powell, Campbell. The Tigers come away. Rogers breaks for him at centre wing. Still Rogers. A bounce. Kicks the half
right
ball.
Kick.
Ah, terrific kick. Richardson. Gasper. Undecided. Gaffey. Looks like Elephant Man's luck child. Evans might have been taken high and rushed over the boundary line.
Great kick there by Rogers, coming onto his left side of the body. I felt Richardson probably led to the wrong spot that stage, made him kick on his left side of the body, but he was equal to the task.
Well, it was just a great takeaway from defence by Richmond. Thought they may have well conceded the behind, but they got it out the back door and away they went.
4 points the margin. Harrison, quick hand pass, snapped by Richardson. Did it hit the post?
Umpire's down.
He is too, he's KO'd.
He got flint. He got shoot from it.
I didn't see what happened, and neither did he.
Pole-latched he was.
We know Richo was incensed at the end of third quarter, but we can categorically state that he wasn't the man because he was kicking the football.
Just there we are.
There it was.
He ran into Richmond Park. Couldn't see who it was. Oh. Umpire Sheehan, I think it is, isn't it? Brian Sheehan.
Yes, Brian Sheehan.
Leading.
Is he going to come off?
Blood rule.
Now, the emergency umpire is Troy Burton.
Can you imagine coming on being your first or second game, Jared? Come on this situation, a game so tight.
He certainly copped a fair whack in the snows.
There it is.
We've got Turk and Carmen out there. Maybe we'll see another mummy come out.
Troy Burton gets the word from Brian Sheehan. I haven't seen an umpire go off for a long while. Can't happen. Let's hope Brian's okay. Good luck. Campbell, quick hand pass, the unmistakable Nick Daffy. Foreman down up high, snap by Bowden, one behind. Well, Bowden's lifted in the last quarter. Now, can the Crows come back? They've got 6.5 minutes, they've trailed by a goal, and you would reckon that if Richmond got even one more behind, it may be enough.
I wouldn't write the Crows off this ground.
No, I'm not writing them off.
Any day, even if they got another goal in front.
Oh, okay. Academy Award performance, Benny. Gasper. Campbell, well done. Harrison. Gee, was he going in solid?
Just around the footy, Doug. I reckon the Tigers are just a notch up on the Crows in desperation.
They certainly are there, Jerry. Particularly in that midfield. Wayne Campbell's lifted his game. He's been a very good player since half-time.
And he got plenty of the footy before. He's had a great game for the Tigers.
Wren, Bickley taken high. Nothing for that. Gee.
Oh, it felt whammy.
Gee. Oh, where's the fourth umpire? We'll become the fifth, sixth and seventh here, but that did look like a free kick to Bickley.
Come back on the ground, Brian Sheehan, please.
Richardson has the mark. That may prove a very costly decision, or lack of one, whichever way you'd like to interpret it.
Well, I think it was a Ricciuto that had his neck taken off.
Bickley.
His head's still on the ground. He's just looking for it. Look at his body.
Hard shot from there.
It is very difficult. He's kicked two goals, Richo. Kicks this. It's going to be difficult for the Crows. Now, Holland's got the mark.
Shot in the fence here, buddy.
And he gives it to Daffy, but the umpire had ordered play, whistle time off.
Run around, there's no one there.
Now we have a look at that tackle. No doubt it was high initially.
And he doesn't run around, but I think he's got it. He has! He's now kicked three, two in the first quarter, and a very telling blow in the last, and Richmond out to a lead of 12 points. They've kicked six goals so far in the final term.
They're home, I reckon. I reckon the Tigers are home here.
I don't think the scoreboard would say that they're absolutely safe, but just the intensity of the Tigers.
Holland kicks his third goal, two in the first quarter and one in the last. 12 points the margin. Have Adelaide got the time and the willpower to come back? Harrison from Wren's knock.
Big last quarter from Harrison.
Connell. Plenty of possessions, but not too many in the final quarter. And the injuries, as Curls pointed out, key players taking their toll. Holland to Michael Gale. Gasper again calls for it and again gets it. Finishing plenty of running. We said earlier the fitter side would win. Maybe it's going to be Richmond. Bassett, good mark. He's been solid. Had plenty of work to do in this quarter. Oh, that's a good mark. Running with the flight of the pill. Kellaway, who's been on Jarman pretty well all day. But Bowden, he really has lifted during, hasn't
he? No doubt. He's been a match winner in this final quarter, along with Benny Harrison. And as a left footer, he's probably a fair chance to kick this one.
I tell you, it's the two boys. Matthew Richardson's been very good in this last quarter.
Yes. Said earlier, the cream coming to the top. Well, it's two goals the difference here. Any score, I think, would give Richmond victory.
It's home.
It is. And so are the Tigers.
Ho-ho.
So three goals to Bowden, who joins Ben Holland as their leading goal kicker. And I think they can start celebrating, Richmond fans and Crows fans in front of us who have thrown in the towel. They're on their way.
I'll tell you what, we saw a great shot of the Richmond cheer squad there. You've got to give credit to any cheer squad member that comes over to football.
Oh, yeah.
It is an unhealthy and a pretty unsafe environment at times, and they're going away with a victory.
Something to savour for Richmond fans after the humiliation of the 137-point drubbing in round 17 last year. Of course, against that, they came back and won four of the last five matches under Geeshan in 97. To miss the five, miss the eight by just a couple of points. Rogers kick towards centre wing. And the other Kellaway, Andrew Kellaway, playing only his second game. Well, you mentioned Richardson.
Been good.
He has, especially in this last quarter. Score answering the challenge, kicking against the breeze. Trailing at three-quarter time, they look down and out, the Tigers. Richardson unloads with a big one. Wren in front, he's tried his heart out, Sean Wren. But injuries to key players taking their toll on Adelaide. Wren, Evans has got him. Jamison, now down in defence, where he's played most of his football in recent times. Michael Gale, the hand pass, a little chip shot to Daffy, the unmistakable Nick Daffy.
Sheesh.
The mice would jump up onto the table when he walked into the room.
Yeah, the crowd are slowly walking out of here at Footy Park, and I'll tell you what, it's the last time I saw that, Jared, as you said, 95 and Fitzroy did it. Shocking sight to see.
I think the bandage typifies the courage of Richmond.
Oh, they've been great.
So Nick Daffy from 45 metres. I think he may have missed the duck. One behind.
Well, they did say look shot to pieces at three-quarter time, the Tigers, and this has been a remarkable turnaround and maybe one of the best victories that they've had in the 90s.
Well, Jared, 19 points down, kicking probably against the score and end. It's been a superb performance by the Tigers.
And they've added seven goals, Doug.
Yep.
And really have never looked like being beaten in the last quarter, I must admit. Gale tries to paddle it out. Rogers does. He's been good. And Michael Gale, like his game as well, very consistent and solid. Knights also lifting. Had a good duel with Costa. Richardson went for the big specky. Couldn't bring it down. Bassett. unloads long hand pass on the end of it. Tyson past Evans. Connell. Connell's kick towards centre wing in a contest. Richmond again at the fall of the ball. Harrison, he's been also very good. Rogers, good tackle. Gale can't nail Bickley. Got to try something. Jamison, well, seemingly playing at both ends of the ground. Rod Jamison, their leading goal kicker today. Taking the kick, came from Vardy. Maybe too little, too late. But 6 goals to Rod Jamison. Richmond will take home the 4 points.
Been a fair upset this one, Doug.
Gee whiz. Well, I mean, I must admit, I didn't give Richmond much chance, even though I was pretty impressed with the way they played against Melbourne last week. But having Adelaide a footy park in front of 40,000, it's a nightmare. And the way the Crows have been going pretty reasonable, so I thought they'd be the one to beat.
They're very disappointed. Malcolm Blight going to the rooms already. Richmond will win there. I'm going to say for the first time this year, will win 2 games in succession. It's been win-loss, etc. right throughout the season. After beating Melbourne last week.
So to Robert Walls during the week, and he said after coaching against the Crows last year and that fateful loss, he looked up on the scoreboard and there was a message at the end of the match: thanks for coming.
Rogers to Evans.
Just wait until the siren to see what creativity the scoreboard master has at the moment.
Harrison, left half forward for Richmond. Richardson, Neely, Evans, he's tough. Connell, oh, gets gang tackled. I think that's typified Richmond's effort in this last quarter. They just wanted the footy a bit more.
Fucking packs, haven't they?
They have. Certainly they looked fitter, but Adelaide with key players on the sidelines through injury.
They've tackled everything and bumped everything inside, Doug, including an umpire.
They knocked him over, Brian Sheen. Has he come back?
And they're starting to sing already, Tiger fans. Kellaway, Duncan Kellaway, can he kick a goal? He can't at 1 minute. And that's rushed through. I don't think it will be a score. It won't matter. Because Richmond has turned around a 137-point thrashing last year to emerge victorious here at Football Park, and for the first time in season 1998, winning 2 games in succession. And what a ground on which to do it.
They also got belted here during the year in the Ansett Cup.
True.
And Jeff Geeshan is down on the ground, and he is absolutely elated. No wonder. He's just about to embrace Tony Jewell, the Tigers' chairman of selectors. And what a